Hello guys and girls, it's Lurgs here, and today how to test your car, van or motorcycle fuses without having to remove them all. So what you've got here is you've got a typical fuse box in your car or your van, and it's full of fuses. And no doubt if you've got a second-hand vehicle, you haven't got a fuse box diagram, so you've got no idea what they are. And if you've got something blown in your car or van, something's not working, you don't want to have to be taking now every single fuse, holding it up to the light and seeing if it's blown or not. I mean, you can do it like that, but I advise you to stop right there, because what you can do is you can test the fuses without having to remove them. Now this is what the fuses look like. These are all my spares, all the good ones. What you're going to need is you're going to need a multimeter, and you can also have a set of pliers because you might need to remove the dodgy one. So this is a typical fuse, and you can see on the top of the fuse you've got the two bits which you can get the multimeter terminals on, and that it completes the circuit. So you can test that without having to remove it. Great little tip. So on your multimeter, you want to set it to the ohm setting on the lowest setting. Mine goes down to 20 ohms, and that's the setting that you want. Right, so now we can start testing the fuses in the fuse box. So at the moment it's not reading anything because I'm not touching anything. So what I'm going to do now is just touch it on the 10 amp, and you've got a reading on there, so that means it is working. That fuse is okay. Now apologies here, I am not an electrician. I don't know anything about electricity. All I know is when I'm in a room, there is electricity. So this is testing the 15 amp one, and that is working. Now what I'm going to do now is test one which I know definitely doesn't work, because I've planted this. So this one is not working, and voila, we've got no reading. Make sure you've got a good connection on the back there on the metal terminals, and we've got no reading. So now if we take this one out, and then go old school and just hold it up to the light, you can see this one is blown. So that's a really handy tip, instead of having to take out every single fuse, which to be honest I've done in the past. So I think that deserves a quick cup of tea.
Hey, careful man, there's a beverage here.
When you're working on the motor, always have a nice cup of tea. So just to show you the fuse when it's out, just to test a working fuse. So you can see in the background the multimeter, we've got a reading on there. This is a good fuse. And just testing it on the top. This is basically just to show you how it works. It's a little bit clearer when it's away from the fuse box. And this is the blown one, which I'm just going to test for you here, just to prove that my theory works. Not that it's a theory, it's just real. And as you can see, no reading. And just to double check on those terminals, no reading. So get yourself a multimeter and you won't have to take out all of your fuses. And that is the end. And if you found that useful, please subscribe. I really, really would appreciate it. And that is today's life hack top tip. Cheers, guys and girls. Check you later.